Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Okay, again, this is Mr. Santos Capilan Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Okay, today what I'm going to do is try to power up my Raspberry Pi 3. In my previous tutorial, I have shown you the Raspberry Pi 4. Now, I have also a Raspberry Pi 3. So, this time, I'm going to use this in doing a very simple project. Okay, now actually I said I'm planning to create some home automation project using Arduino and Raspberry Pi. Okay, so I'm planning to use this Raspberry Pi 3 as part of my home automation. Okay, so first, what are the ports available in this Raspberry Pi 3? Now I have here 4 USB ports. Okay, then I think this is USB 2.0. Now I have here my Ethernet port, okay, for my hardwired LAN. Okay, then what else? I have here the sound jack. Okay, then this one is using an ordinary HDMI. Okay, now in Raspberry Pi 4 they are using this micro HDMI, but here it is an ordinary HDMI port. Then the power supply will be this micro USB, okay? Now, actually, you need to provide a power supply that is capable of, up to around 2.5 amperes, okay? Now, if you are using a power supply lesser than that, it might not work, okay? Now, again, this one, there will be no hard drive, so we are using this SD card for our operating system and some of the files that we are going to use, okay? I mean, like in the programming. So, those files will be stored in this SD card, okay? Now, what I had here is my GPIO header. So, these are my GPIO header. Now, the first pin here, I think, is the 3.3. So, pin number 1 is 3.3 volts, okay? Then, the pin assignment is like this: pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, pin 5, pin 6. So, meaning the first row will be the add pin numbers. Then, the top row will be the even pin numbers. Okay, so pin 1 will be 3.3 volts. Then, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, pin 5, pin 6 is ground. Okay, so we will be using this pin 6 for our ground connection. Then pin number 1, 2, 3, so pin number 7 will be our GPIO number 4. Okay, I'll be using that one also in this project. Then I will be using GPIO 17. Okay, now actually there will be a table showing all the pin assignment for this GPIO header. Okay, so this will be our input and output pins. Okay, if you remember, in our Arduino we have also these input pins for analog and digital pins, but this time the Raspberry Pi, it has a GPIO header here. This one around I think this one around 40 pins. Okay, so I'll be using this in my home automation. Okay, now the programming that I will be using here is Python. Okay, as you know, Python is an object oriented programming. Okay, so let me connect the devices that I'm going to use. Okay, make sure it's properly inserted. Okay, now I will also use this hardwired LAN, okay, because you can pull some of the application in the internet. Okay, now also this one is having also the wireless LAN. Okay, so let me connect the power. Okay, so just be very careful in inserting it, then always support your board. Okay, because as you can see, your computer, this mini computer, is very small, so you need to be very careful also in inserting the cables. Okay, so now it's ready. Okay, now let me explain here my breadboard. I have a breadboard here. Okay, now we have here the negative and the positive line here, okay? Now, also at the other side, I have also the negative and the positive. So, this is where you will provide the negative and the power supply. As I said, we're going to use the 3.3 volts, okay? Now, here, I already have here two LED because I'm planning to show you the very first simple project that we can do for this Raspberry Pi. Now, here, I have here two LED with two current limiting resistors. Why do we need to put a current limiting resistors here? Guys, as per recommendation for this Raspberry Pi, as much as possible, we will just limit the current of the component that we are connecting or the current being drawn by the component up to 2 milliamps, okay? So, this one, by using this current limiting resistor, the current drawn by this LED will be less than 2 milliamps, okay? So, I'm using here a 680, then you can just compute the, because if we are going to drive this using 3.3 volts, then this LED will be having a positive voltage drop, okay? I think this one is, will have around 2 volts voltage drop. So, meaning 3.3 minus 2 volts around, I have 1.3. Then, if you are using this current limiting resistor by using the Ohm's law, you can compute for the current. Okay, so the current is less than 2 milliamps. Okay, so my LED negative LED is already connected to my negative line. Okay, so I have a negative line here where I will provide the ground connection to my Raspberry Pi. Okay, so let me connect. So first, the ground, as I said, the ground we're using is pin number 6. Okay, then pin number 7 is our GPIO number 4. Okay, so this is my GPIO number 4. GPIO number 4 will be the one to drive my first LED here. Okay, then my, I think, 17 GPIO 17. Okay, so I will just insert it anywhere here. Okay, so I think this one. Okay, now I will check it later. Okay, but anyway, I will be using just this first LED to show you the programming using Python. Okay, now actually you can do the programming in two ways. One is in you write the entire, I mean the program, in an IDE, okay, or you can control the LED through the Python shell. Okay, so let me show that one. But first, let us power up. So my monitor is already on, so let me power up my okay, so I power up my Raspberry Pi. Okay, now it is already showing my desktop. Okay, now actually my problem is my mirror at the back is reflecting my reflected in my monitor. Okay, so anyway, I will try to focus so that you will see. Okay, now actually I already written the program for controlling this simple LED project. Okay, now as I said, this is my desktop. Now this is the, okay, so this is where you will start. Now I have here the programming, so I will just try to explain to you how are you going to program it. Okay, now as I said, we can program it in two ways. First, we can use the IDE. So we have also an IDE here, as in Arduino we have also our Arduino IDE. Here we have a Python IDE. Okay, now I can program it also here. This is my okay, let me show you. Okay, so this is my, okay, the problem is I don't know if you will see it. Okay, because of my okay, so this is my shell. Okay, so this is my Python IDE. Okay, so let me open. Okay, so let me just, okay, so let me open the program that I have written. Okay, so I think that is the flash LED. Okay, so flash LED 2, let's see. Okay, so this will be again. I don't let me open the very first one. I think this is the plus LED only. Okay, so let me adjust my window. Okay, so as you can see, guys, this is my program. Okay, so this is Python programming. Okay, so the first line here is from GPIO0 import LED. Now this is, I think, the library. Then I am importing the LED object. Okay, so LED object, I'm trying to import it in my program. Then from time, okay, time library, I'm importing my sleep object. Okay, so actually the equivalent of this sleep is our in Arduino, this is the delay. Okay, so now I'm trying to declare a variable here. Okay, that is LED equals LED. So I'm using now the LED object. Then I will need to provide one argument here. Okay, so it's just like in Arduino, we are trying to configure the variable and point it to the GPIO0. So this is our GPIO4. So this is our GPIO4. Okay, so I'm pointing my variable LED, or I'm assigning a value to my LED, which is the LED object. Then I'm saying the GPIO number 4. Okay, now in line number 6, I'm using here a repetition structure. Okay, so this is our repetition structure. Okay, so while true, then colon, this is the syntax for Python. Okay, so LED, I'm using my LED variable. Then since it is pointing to the LED object, then I'm trying to access the on function or the on method. Okay, so LED dot on function, then sleep. Now I'm using the sleep object. Then I'm providing one argument here, which is 1, meaning 1 second. Then line number 9, I'm turning off my LED. Okay, then providing again a delay, or a delay of 1 second. Then after that, it will go back to my since this is repetition structure, so it will repeat till it is true. Until if it is true, then it will keep just repeating this. So it's just like we are simulating the on and off of the LED. Okay, now what you can do, you can here you can turn it on here, or you can run your program. Okay, so I can turn this on. Okay, so my LED now is flashing, as you can see here. Okay, so it is flashing based on the program. So 1 second it will be on, then 1 second it will be off. Then again, since we are using the repetition structure, it will be repeated forever and forever until you stop the program. Okay, now you can stop the running program in our Raspberry Pi by, okay, let me show you again. Now I have here the stop. Okay, so I have here my stop. Okay, so this one will stop the program running in our Raspberry Pi. So I will try to stop it. Okay, now the program is stopped. Then my LED is no longer working because the program driving it is already stopped. Okay, now as I said previously, you can control this LED through the let me show you here. Okay, now through my Python shell. Okay, so I have here my Python shell here. Okay, now let me see if I can focus you to my, okay, this is the problem, I cannot focus my, okay, so let's see if I can, bear with me, huh. Okay, now can you see it? Is it still visible? Okay, let me, why I cannot adjust my camera. Okay, so anyway, there, as I hope you can still see my screen. Okay, let me adjust my devices here so I can freely type on the keyboard. Okay, so here what I'm going to do, okay, let's see if you can see this still. Okay, there's my cursor. Now I will try to control the LED in my Python shell. Okay, so first I need to import the LED. So from, so I will just type. Okay, now no problem is I cannot see what I'm typing here. Okay, so let me just focus to here. Okay, so we'll see if you can now. I think is this now visible. So from GPIO0 import LED. Okay, enter. Then I will declare the variable, then point it to my GPIO. Okay, then I can use the variable LED dot on, call the on function. Okay, so as you can see, my LED is already working. Okay, so from the Raspberry Pi shell, you can control it. Okay, so I can say also LED. Okay, now I'm typing that off, so I'm calling the off function. Okay, enter. Now as you can see, it is off. Okay, now again I will try to, okay, let me see if I can, so you can see what I'm doing in my keyboard. So I will type LED that on. Okay, as you can see, it's turning on. Okay, so I can say again LED dot off. Okay, wait, there's some problem there. Okay, enter. Now as you can see, this is the very nice feature of Raspberry Pi, because from the Raspberry Pi shell, you can, I mean from the Python shell, you can control the LED. Okay, also there are two ways. First, you can write the entire program, then run it, see how it works, or you can test your program in the Python shell. But of course, you can just test your program, a simple program, in Python shell. Okay, so if you have a complicated program, of course you need to use the IDE. okay, so guys, if you are new to my YouTube channel, you can always subscribe, and you can also click the notification bell so that you will be notified for my next tutorial in this Raspberry Pi 3 series tutorial. Okay, now I'm planning to create several projects in my Raspberry Pi 3 tutorial covering home automation. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this simple tutorial, and I do hope for those engineering student or engineering graduates who are planning to join building management system or building automation system, you will learn something from my YouTube channel. And please, you can also share, like, and comment. And Santos Cabrera Jr. will always end my tutorial in saying God bless us all, and let's all be safe, and bye for now.